நீயில்லாத நாளல்ல நாளாகுமா நீயில்லாத வாழ்வல்ல வாழ்வாகுமா
Book of 1 Kings chapter 17 verse 5 So he did what the Lord had told him. He went to the Kerit River east of the Jordan and stayed there. Now the Lord says to Elijah, Elijah, go and hide yourself in the Kerit River until the drought comes to an end. You stay hidden in that place, and that I shall command the ravens to provide you with food, said the Lord. Accordingly, Elijah went to stay hidden in the gorge of Kerit. For over a year, God had provided him with bread and meat for every morning and evening through the ravens. And to quench his thirst, he would drink from the river. He was very safe for a year. The Lord did this in order to protect him from the hands of Ahab and Jezebel. The place where he stayed was the Kerit River. This river of Kerit was a small water stream that was south to Jordan. It wasn't a great river, but a small stream. Water will be found in it seasonally. During rainy seasons, water flows from it, and during summer, it runs dry. Kerit is a small stream that flows toward Jordan to join it. Why did the Lord protect Elijah in such a place? God had thus hid him there because for a massive revival, God trained his minister, his servant. God had hid, felt like this, and trained his minister in faith for a massive ministry and revival. Kerit Ravin became a place where the Lord fed Elijah and strengthened his faith. If you see in the Bible, before God would use Apostle Paul, it did not happen immediately. The Bible says in Galatians chapter 1 verse 17, he got trained in the region of Arab for 3 years by God, after which he started his ministry and was then used by the Lord in a mighty way. Hence, before such a great revival, God will hide his people, his servants, in this way. He will lead them through a struggle and train them in faith. Children of God, these days of struggle means the Lord is leading his church, his ministry, and his believers towards a great revival. This will soon come to an end, and when that happens, he's going to bring a great revival to the nation through the church, through his ministry. For the time has come for the Lord to do wonders with mere and simple believers. God is shaping you not to destroy or hurt you, not to send us into rejection and humiliation, the latest suppressors. But these are the days of preparation. Just as for Elijah and Apostle Paul, the Lord is preparing us. God's children who are listening, when you are spiritual through this experience, the Lord will never leave you needy. He will perfectly do things at its time. To those who first seek the kingdom of God, he will automatically give you the worldly blessings, and God will honor you. Hallelujah. God bless you.